gonna stand up, sing hallelujah. Hallelujah. Show praise with your body, stand up, sing hallelujah. Hallelujah. And if you can't stop shaking, lean back, let it move right through you. And say your prayers, say your prayers, say your prayers.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Macomb Center for the Performing Arts. Please turn off all cell phones and electronic devices, and note that photography or recording of any kind is strictly prohibited. At this time, please locate your nearest emergency exit. In the event of an emergency, proceed quickly and calmly to that exit. And now, the 2017 State of the County with Macomb County Executive Mark Hackel.
I'm her, but I feel like Beyonce. Good evening, Macomb Countyers, Macombers, Macomanomers. What do we call ourselves? Not Klingons. Whatever we are, I am one of you. My husband, yep, thank you, right there. My husband and I moved here 3 years ago. We increased your population by 5 and 170 dog pounds. I'm Paula Tupman from Local 4, and it is my honor to be here this evening. And in fact, like I said, we've only been here for about 3 years. When John Swickler called and asked me to introduce the county exec this evening, I was so honored. And I said, wow, John, wow, this is really cool. And he said, well, we needed somebody from Macomb County. We needed somebody in the meet. It's not that big a deal. We were running out of options. I'm so glad I made Macomb my home. It has been amazing because I see firsthand the great things this county is doing. I have an opportunity to tell our stories in a very meaningful way, I see the housing starts. And I know that we've got income growth, and I know we have population growth. And it's really, really exciting. But perhaps I am not the one to anchor that kind of news story. Why don't we welcome to the stage none other than your executive Macomb County-ian, County Executive Mark Hackel.
Welcome to Macomb County, and thank you for joining us for the annual State of the County Address. Paula, thank you for that incredibly kind introduction. You know, it's funny, we choreographed that one take, one and done, and that was kind of our back bump type thing if you didn't notice it, okay? I do appreciate the times when you and WDIV have helped us really get the good word out about what's happening here in Macomb County. And more importantly, I do want to thank you for making Macomb your home. Ladies and gentlemen, Paula Tutman. Now, I do have to take a little bit of time at the front end of this to kind of recognize some other people who are joining us this evening. It's something that I like to do. And first, it's our regional partners who took the time to actually show up here and be a part of this. So first, help me give a warm Macomb County welcome to Wayne County Executive Warren Evans. Warren, where are you at? Representing Oakland County Executive L. Brooks Patterson is Deputy Executive Phil Bertolini. Phil? And representing the City of Detroit, the Mayor of the City of Detroit, Mike Duggan, Chief Operating Officer Dave Masseron, and Chief of Staff Alexis Wiley. You didn't think I was going to forget you. The Chairman of the St. Clair County Board of Commissioners, Mr. Jeff Bohm. Also with us is the Chairman of the Macomb County Board of Commissioners, Bob Smith. We also have the newly appointed President of Oakland University, Dr. Ora Peskovitz. Ora? And newly appointed President of Walsh College, Marsha Kelleher. Marsha? I'll mention the countywide elected officials as well. Prosecutor Eric Smith, Treasurer Larry Rocca, Clerk Karen Spranger, Sheriff Anthony Wickersham, and our Public Works Commissioner, Candace Miller. Joining us as well are the Macomb County Circuit and District Court Judges, led by Chief Judge James Biernat. Thank you all. Thank you all for your service. And a special thank you to our presenting sponsor, St. John Providence, along with the other sponsors who are listed in your program. Also, Macomb and Sterling Heights Chamber. I have to give a special thank you for helping us put this program together. Grace and Melanie, thank you very much for the work you did. And almost lastly, I want to thank our host, Macomb Community College, that is now under the leadership of its newly appointed president, and I am certain it's in great hands under the leadership of Dr. Jim Sawyer. Jim, where are you at? They turn the lights down too soon. I get a flashlight for you next year. So. But again, out of all those recognitions, probably the two most prominent, two most important to me are my wife, Tracy. And a guy who tries not to get too much attention, but he's there supporting me every step of the way since I was a newborn child here in Macomb County, my father. It's hard for me to believe that tonight we are celebrating the 7th annual State of Macomb County. This past 7 years has been filled with its share of successes that we kind of track with 5 key metrics. First, our ever-growing population and diversity. Since 2010, more than 12 people a day have made Macomb their home. That's 12 people a day since 2010. And just last year, we added 3,000 new residents. Our minority population continues to grow. and 10% of Macomb County residents are foreign-born. Second, rising educational attainment. Since 2010, Macomb County's education has added more than 22,000 associates, bachelor's, and graduate degrees. Third, family income levels. In 2015, Macomb's median household income rose by 9%. This is one of the largest increases in the state and brings Macomb County's household income back to above the state average. Fourth, jobs are on the rise here in Macomb County. Our unemployment rate stands at 4.1%. This year, our workforce rose more than 440,000 individuals, returning us to near historic highs in jobs. And our fifth metric is housing. In 2016, we added more than 1,400 housing units to Macomb County, and the median home value increased by nearly $9,000. I'm going to be talking a little bit more about that later on. But, you know, I like to believe that some of this momentum is as a result of the brand we launched 7 years ago. Make Macomb your home. We knew Macomb had a lot to offer, and Make Macomb Your Home became our way of showcasing that to the world. Today, it has become widely recognized as the banner that unites Macomb County. Through Macomb, MakeMacombYourHome.com, we have developed a comprehensive community calendar, created interactive maps to help us navigate the county, provided educational and enrichment resources for children, and most recently, we promoted a Shop Local program in support of small businesses. Make Macomb Your Home is more than just a website. It has evolved into a digital force.
Where you live. It's no small decision. In fact, it's one of the biggest. Because where you live isn't just about an address or even a house. It's where your life happens. It's about becoming a part of a place, and at the same time, that place becoming a part of you. There are a lot of things to consider when choosing a place to live: great neighborhoods, vibrant communities, and award-winning schools. You might choose it because of its unique location, natural beauty, or access to recreation. That's not only good for your heart, but good for your soul. Somewhere you truly feel welcome, and not only know your neighbors, but consider them friends. A place that offers high-tech jobs in diverse industries with a rich history of creativity and innovation. Where access to world-class healthcare is just a short drive away, and there's a comfort knowing that a caring community surrounds you through every stage of your life. When you find that place that has not just one, but all of these things, that big decision suddenly gets smaller. And that's when you'll know you're home.
It just dawned on me as I'm watching this and realizing that Brooks had to have a representative here today. I think he's getting tired of my self-promoting videos that we put out there in our commercials. But as I mentioned, talking about this website evolving into a digital force that we have here in Macomb County, there are now more than 25,000 ambassadors who are sharing content on social media platforms. Each month, our posts are seen by more than 122,000 people. And throughout the year, nearly 1.5 million people from 49 countries have been connected to our community by using Make Macomb Your Home. Simply put, Make Macomb Your Home is raising the global profile of Macomb County. Over the past 7 years, the charter form of government has allowed us to refocus county services through new leadership, programming, technology, and creative partnerships. It's not just because we move some boxes around on an organizational chart. We're working to instill a sense of purpose and provide our employees with the opportunity to inject passion and creativity into their work. You see, it's not about what we do, it's about why we do it. We are seeing these changes take place in areas like our Health and Community Services Division. Our health department recently achieved reaccreditation with commendation, meaning our team achieved all 160 accreditation indicators during this review. The medical examiner's office was also reaccredited by the National Association of Medical Examiners. In fact, only 10% of medical examiners' offices across the country achieve this distinction. Beyond these accreditations, the health department launched our Nurse Family Partnership Program. This evidence-based community health program connects nurses with first-time mothers in their home to improve pregnancy outcomes, encourage preventative health practices, and enhance child health and development. Our Macomb Community Action Agency is improving people's lives. The Family Resource Centers are a prime example of this. In 2015, we developed a concept to create dynamic community centers offering vital services by housing key partners in a single strategic location. We started with our first center in Warren, expanded to Mount Clemens, and recently opened up a new center in New Haven. This past year, these resource centers have provided essential community services to 6,000 families. We are also developing new initiatives to aid some of our most vulnerable populations. Our Head Start and Innovative Fund received a $125,000 grant to better prepare children for social and academic successes. The Mobile Fresh Pantry program leveraged $75,000 from the Healthy Food Connect program to provide meals for nearly 1,300 senior citizens. And our health and financial resource fairs, they've linked hundreds of county families to wellness and financial literacy programs. The county has also expanded its One Macomb initiative to help us better understand the changing dynamics of the population we are serving. One Macomb is a county program established to embrace, share, and celebrate our increasing diversity. This year, we received the Gateways for Growth Challenge Grant from the New American Economy Initiative. This grant provided One Macomb with an opportunity to develop a strategic plan for making Macomb County more inclusive. With 30 partnering agencies, we gathered data, facilitated conversations, connected resource networks, and explored how diversity and cultural awareness are shaping the future of Macomb County. As a result, Macomb Active Cultural Togetherness, known as Macomb ACT, was formed. This initiative is helping us create strategic responses focused on community relations in law enforcement, refugee assistance, education and economic development, and expanded access to community resources. Our population is more diverse than it's ever been, and initiatives like Macomb ACT are ensuring that our county is welcoming to all. Our human resource department, they're helping recruit talent with two new initiatives. We recently signed a partnership agreement with Oakland University to offer expanded intern opportunities for their students, and worked with Macomb Community College in hosting a public sector career expo where students could discuss career pathways with county administrators. Our facilities and operations, the restoration and transformation of the county's downtown campus continues. Both the Old County building, some people refer to that, and the Talmer building renovations are complete. The next phase of our capital program, we're going to be modernizing our court building by adding additional courtrooms and upgrading technology. I know you've heard me say this before, but when it comes to finances, this is something I'm glad to say again. Everything we have accomplished has been aided by 7 consecutive years of structurally balanced budgets and our ability to maintain a AA+ bond rating. Fiscal stability will always be a cornerstone of our administration. Next, the county's economic edition. Get ready for a ride. Macomb County has developed into an economic powerhouse. 18,000 Macomb County companies employ more than 320,000 individuals. Each day, some of the most advanced companies in the world are doing work in ways never done before. You see, there's a science behind our economic development efforts. In fact, I kind of call our economic department, the folks in there, JP and Vicky Red, the mad scientists. They've come up with a creative, data-driven model which has helped our county adapt to emerging needs of industry. And they're breaking down this outdated perception about our local economy. Take, for example, automotive. Automotive has always been a, I guess if you will, dominant part of our economy, or just a dominant industry. The transformation of the auto industry is opening up economic opportunities across Macomb County. 470 Macomb County automotive firms employ nearly 33,000 individuals. Since 2010, automotive companies have invested more than $8.3 billion in Macomb County. General Motors is now testing fully autonomous vehicles in Macomb County and developing industry-leading R&D from their Global Technical Center in Warren. Ford, $150 million investment, adding 130 jobs at Romeo Engine, expanding capacity for the next generation Ranger and Bronco. Fiat Chrysler, completing a $1.4 billion investment in the Sterling Heights Assembly Plant and committing an additional $1 billion to its Warren Truck Facility to produce the all-new Jeep Wagoneer and Grand Wagoneer. Our top-tier auto suppliers are also making substantial investments. Companies like Grupo Antolin, 61 million, 430 jobs. Flexengate, 18 million, 290 jobs. And AGS Automotive, 12 million, 175 new jobs. These investments highlight the resurgence of the auto industry and how well these companies have positioned themselves for the future. Defense. You heard me say it time and again. Macomb is the defense capital. Today, Macomb County is home to nearly 700 defense contractors. Last year, this network of county companies were awarded 3,000 defense contracts. This year, it's up an incredible 50%, 4,500 contracts, which amounted to $1.8 billion in contracts awarded. We continue to be a leader in defense programming and innovation. For example, TARDAC and General Motors have expanded their partnership on fuel cell technologies that are being tested for both military and civilian deployments. BAE Systems is investing $11 million in their new dynamometer test lab at their ground vehicle center in Sterling Heights. Working alongside the Michigan Defense Center, Macomb County was awarded a $285,000 grant to help protect and grow this defense industry. Once again, the defense mission here in Macomb County is clear. We are doing things that protect those who protect us. Advanced manufacturing. The integration of knowledge-based information technology with traditional manufacturing resources is helping Macomb County companies become leaders in Industry 4.0. Robotics, automation, modeling, simulation, advanced materials are being integrated into the fabric of Macomb manufacturing. The result, more than 1,600 Macomb County manufacturers employing 64,000 individuals, earning an average wage of $86,000 a year. These local companies are making impressive investments. Century Plastics, 16 million, 103 new jobs. Futuramic, 15 million, 45 jobs. Summit Plastic, 8 million, 35 jobs. And Baker Industries, 3.5 million, 25 new jobs. I almost want to apologize because I can't name them all. And that's because these are just a few of the advanced manufacturing firms that are revolutionizing the way things are made in Macomb. Another targeted industry, IT and cybersecurity. Macomb County has moved to the cutting edge of IT and cybersecurity. More than 400 companies make up Macomb County's knowledge network and collectively employ nearly 9,000 individuals who are utilizing some of the world's most sophisticated software systems. Since 2010, the national average for employment growth in IT and cybersecurity was 15%. 2010, national growth in this area, 15%. In Macomb County, during that same period, the growth was 136%. This impressive growth can be attributed to assets like the Michigan Cyber Range, where certifications in more than 20 different cybersecurity disciplines are offered. We're also expanding the Michigan Automotive and Defense Cyber Assurance Team. Say that fast. We've condensed it and we call it MADCAT. This year, MADCAT has turned its sights on developing talent. Leveraging a grant from the MEDC, MADCAT is creating a cybersecurity career pathway in partnering with higher education and industry experts. Walsh College, for example, just launched a groundbreaking program in automotive cybersecurity. These kinds of initiatives will ensure that we have the talent we need to remain leaders in cybersecurity. Healthcare. Healthcare, one of our fastest growing industries. Residents now have access to a continuum of care, ranging from urgent care to trauma centers. 4 nationally ranked hospital systems provide access to world-class healthcare right here at home. In fact, St. John Providence just began work on their Macomb Tower expansion project in Warren. This $48 million transformation will add 3 floors to the existing hospital tower. They will triple the number of private rooms and dramatically increase capacity, speed of patient care, and patient satisfaction. And when the project is completed, it will bring 100 additional healthcare jobs to Macomb County. The final targeted industry I would like to highlight is logistics. The movement of goods and services is big business. More than 500 Macomb County companies are involved in transportation and logistics, and they employ nearly 9,000 individuals. But you know what? I think the strength of this industry can be summed up in one word: Amazon. I get those packages on the front porch. She's going to do it back to me because she knows I'm just as bad. So, and we do shop local. So one of the world's largest and most influential companies just recently decided to make Macomb their home. Amazon is actually locating a 1 million square foot facility. I can't even fathom what that looks like. $70 million is what they're actually investing in this logistic optimization center right here in Shelby Township. And if that ain't enough, it's bringing 1,000 new jobs to Macomb County. And by the way, something that I really get excited about because it's environmental issues, and I know I share that same thought with Candace Miller here, the county's brownfield program is facilitating a $10 million environmental cleanup at that site. That's a big deal. You know, but credit goes to the people that brought this deal together. It was Shelby Township, the Michigan Economic Development Corporation, some very notable national developers, and I'm proud to say, led by a team within our planning department, John Paul Ray, Vicky Rad. I got to tell you, our planning department working together. This, without question, folks, is one of the biggest business attraction deals in the history of Macomb County, and we are very proud of that work. Now, clearly, there's a tremendous amount of economic activity happening in Macomb County. So what will it take to maintain this momentum? I think there are 2 things: talent and infrastructure. All this investment in innovation cannot continue unless we develop the necessary talent to provide adequate infrastructure. First, let's discuss talent. When we ask businesses to tell us their greatest need, the answer was almost always talent. Scratch that. It was always talent. There are currently more than 15,000 unfilled jobs here in Macomb County. So here's what we're doing to help. We coordinate one of the largest Manufacturing Day celebrations in the nation. And in the past 5 years, we have helped nearly 7,000 students explore emerging career opportunities. You know, rather than me tell you about it, here's a quick video from some of those who have benefited from the program.
Partnering with Manufacturing Day has helped us get some students. What I mean by that is some of the students that have come in here have seen opportunities within PTI itself and wanted to become part of it once they graduate from high school.
It really just kind of brought to my attention that this is what I need to be doing. And they showed me step by step the whole process of tool building and tool making, and I was just immediately drawn to it.
I got to go on the floor and see robots move with the tool and these huge robots, and to think about like programming the line to go through and the tool or the part to like flow through the cells. It seems so cool to actually be able to be a part of it.
My first year of high school, I went to Futuramic, where they make aerospace parts, and they have a lot of high technologies over there. I really liked it, and there where I get the idea from what I want to do in my future. So I kind of started from there.
I didn't expect that's what it was going to be like. Everything was in so much detail. There were so many different companies out there just trying to kind of convince people that, hey, go into this field, this is what you want to do. And, you know, I enjoyed it. I loved every minute of it.
What started as a single day event has turned into a year-long commitment to work with businesses and educators. One of the outcomes was the first outcomes that we had actually seen and we kind of embarked upon was the Ford Next Generation Learning Program in Romeo. This new academy-based program better aligns curriculum with careers and better assures that what is being taught in a classroom is actually being used in the workplace. We're going to continue being committed to working with our industry and educational partners to provide other innovative solutions to develop talent. But let's talk about that second area of concern, and that's infrastructure. Just as business leaders tell us their greatest need is talent, the public tells us their greatest infrastructure needs are roads. This past year, we completed 34 major road projects, invested $32 million in construction and repair, and rehabilitated 4 bridges. We partnered with some local communities to improve subdivisions and completed 2 major projects with MDOT along M59 and 33 Mile Road to help expand investment opportunities. But let's face it, current funding sources are not adequate to solve all the problems. Even with this challenge, we are proud to say that all of our road projects have been and will continue to be designed with an eye towards the future. As a result, Macomb County possesses one of the most advanced, intelligent transportation systems in the entire country. Why do I say that? Currently, we have 540 interconnected traffic signals. There are 220 real-time traffic monitoring cameras, 152 miles of connected roadways. In fact, 50,000 vehicles per day now travel on connected corridors right here in Macomb County. These technological advancements are making our roadways safer, more efficient, and makes us better prepared to deploy connected and autonomous vehicles than anywhere in the country. While roads are the infrastructure we see every day, infrastructure underground is just as important. Nowhere, nowhere was this more important than the unprecedented sewer collapse along 15 Mile Road. This had a major impact on residents, businesses, and commuters. I am pleased to say that just yesterday, Candace Miller and her team completed a year-long effort to repair the collapse on time, on budget, and with no discharges into our waterways. Good job. By design, an annual State of the County speech looks back over the past year, as we've been doing. But a month from now, Macomb County will begin looking much further back, 200 years to be exact. Macomb was established as Michigan's third county on January 15th, 1818. I got to pause here. We were established as Michigan's third county. Now, first goes to Warren Evans and Wayne County. Second, I guess many of you would assume, would be Oakland County. This is an educational moment for you. And because Brooks isn't here, I get to take this opportunity. Tell him I was talking behind his back. I'm sure we're going to be here. No, it was actually Monroe. Monroe was the second. So the only thing old about Oakland County, I'd say it. Oh, shame on you. What the heck? Phil, I didn't say a word. Beginning next month, there will be a series of events to mark our bicentennial. Some of these events will include a birthday celebration, unique participation in parades and festivals, and one of my favorite things that's going to be very exciting is a 200-mile non-stop torch relay that will pass through every community. For a full list, for those of you that are interested, on what is actually happening during this next year, you can go to Macomb200.org or one of my favorite websites, MakeMacombYourHome.com. As with any milestone anniversary, much of the attention will focus on how things have changed over the years. So each of us, we know, kind of has a mental image of the county, its characteristics, and its role within the region. Those images, though, cause us to think and act in certain ways. But what if our view of things don't match reality? Well, that can lead to some bad decisions, and in government, sometimes it can lead to poor public policy. So I want to, and I hope that we do, use this opportunity with this bicentennial to kind of sharpen our image of what's been happening in Macomb and the Tri-County region. Here are some examples of what I mean. We know, like most American communities, early population growth in Macomb was driven by immigration. Our first settlers were French fur trappers and German missionaries, followed by other Western Europeans. But what we may not know is that just as immigration drove our earliest population growth, it is driving that growth again today. In fact, the majority of the county's population growth these past few years was a result of international immigration. Without it, our population would have been stagnant. An interesting fact I had heard, the Macomb Intermediate School District told us, there are now 116 different languages and dialects spoken in our county. So while people may be coming from different countries, immigrants are still choosing Macomb County for the same reasons. A chance for a better quality of life, enhanced economic opportunities, and most of all, its welcoming atmosphere. We are proud that Macomb County has been recognized nationally as a welcoming community. Another image we may need to adjust is the population trend in the Tri-County region. See if you can answer this question. You didn't know this was going to be an educational moment. First, you found out who the first three counties in the state were. And Oakland, I don't even know what they ended up being, but it wasn't one, two, or three. looking back, let's say some 50 years, 1970, how has the total population in the Tri-County region changed? Did it A, grow by 21%, B, grow by 5%, or C, did it decline by 8%? Do, 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 do. You're thinking, aren't you? I got the judges all sitting here trying to figure this out. One of them spoke up, and you're actually right. You may be surprised, but the answer is C. The regional population declined by 8%. That's interesting. The total population of Wayne, Oakland, and Macomb counties hit its peak in 1970 when it began to decline. Today, the population of the Tri-County region is back to where it was in the 1960s. So our mental image of regional population has to be one of major population shift rather than one of population growth. Let's look more closely now at how that shift occurred. In 1950, nearly 400,000 more people lived in the city of Detroit than in the rest of Wayne, Oakland, and Macomb counties combined. But in the decade following World War II, people began relocating. Many Detroit families moved to the suburbs, as did businesses, retail, and major job-producing industries. In fact, I'm going to bet you there are probably many of you here in this room that can relate to some of these stories or changes. This trend has been steady and persistent. By the mid-1980s, the population in the balance of Wayne County became larger than its major city. By 1990, the population of Oakland County surpassed Detroit. And in the early 2000s, Macomb also surpassed Detroit. The point is simply this. While the last half century did not bring about population growth to the region, it did produce a major shift in where people have chosen to live. Now, let's turn our attention from population to jobs. There are now more than 1.7 million jobs in the Tri-County region, an increase of almost 14% since 2010. But like population change, job growth in the region has also been uneven. Since 2010, there has been 18% job growth in Oakland County, 17% in Macomb, 10% in out-county Wayne, and 4.8% in Detroit. The combination of population shifts and job growth has radically altered commuting patterns in the Tri-County area. The historic north-south pattern has been replaced by a dominant east-west orientation. Now, more Macomb residents drive west to work than south, and nearly 40,000 Oakland County workers continue or commute to jobs here in Macomb. As you can see, the past 50 years have brought about some tangible changes to regional population, job location, and commuting patterns. So why is all this so significant, or why should we be thinking about it? It's because public policy hasn't always recognized these changes. In the future, public policy discussions have to be based on more how things are, rather than how they used to be. I'd like to conclude my remarks this evening by highlighting a few things that are on the horizon for this county. First, the F-35s. As you know, Selfridge is one of the five bases being considered as home to these next generation fighters. And all things being equal, they are not. Selfridge is the most logical choice based on mission readiness and economic readiness, the realities of the economy. But unfortunately, logic doesn't always drive decisions. The support on this effort has been absolutely inspiring. From the governor, congressional delegation, local communities, base council, chambers, and the list goes on. If we don't win, it will most certainly not be based upon the lack of solid rationale or support. We, along with General Slocum, who is here with us tonight, and Team Selfridge, are anxiously awaiting that decision. General? We're with him. Next, criminal justice reform. I am pleased to report that progress is being made. Outside experts have already provided excellent insight into how processes can be streamlined and improved. The county will soon be conducting a study to determine specific facility needs. And there is now a much better coordination among county agencies to deal with various aspects of the criminal justice system. But we have to admit that a major concern will be funding. It will be all but impossible to make substantial improvements without enhanced funding. And you know what, somewhat related to criminal justice reform is the need to better address the substance abuse issues. Although we have made some progress, and despite our best efforts, the challenge still remains. Substance abuse and the much-publicized opioid epidemic are impacting many people's lives, but so too has it really put a burden, cost burden, on the sheriff, the prosecutor, health department, medical examiner, and other county agencies. As a result, and partnered with the Board of Commissioners, we have decided to retain, or we're going to be retaining, the Bernstein Law Firm from Farmington Hills and Weitz Luxembourg from New York to help initiate litigation to help recover these additional costs from drug manufacturers and distributors. And in the meantime, county agencies are continuing to work with community groups to help alleviate drug and alcohol dependencies. Another item is indigent defense. The state recently enacted several new standards and is considering a mandate that would shift the responsibility of indigent defense from the courts to the executive office. Where that plays out or where it ends up, I really don't know, and we'll see. But in the meantime, we've been working closely together with all the partnerships in this, and I do believe that these new standards possibly could, you know, add some additional burdens, but I think if it's designed properly in working together, this could have an impact on not only providing rightful, I guess, opportunities for those that are being accused, but also ease some of the concerns we have with our jail overcrowding. We're also going to be doing something to update our master plan for our parks and natural resources this coming year. Boy, it's incredible what we've already been able to accomplish. We plan to build on that foundation, and to do so with some unique thinking. Here's an example. We've all heard about the successful program of converting rails to trails. Well, now working with Candace Miller's office, we are exploring the feasibility of a first-of-a-kind drain trails program. There are miles of these beautiful open waterways that crisscross Macomb County, many of them traversing natural landscapes that could easily be made walkable. I mean, right here in the heart of Macomb County. Opening those spaces to the public would provide huge community benefits with a very minimal public investment. This fits very well into the county's continuing effort to improve water quality. In fact, we're right now connecting with the Huron-Clinton Metropolitan Authority and a group of state experts to focus on reducing the number of beach closures at that beach. And we're going to do it through enhanced testing and pollution source tracking, habitat restoration, and as weird as it may sound, even beach design enhancements. We have a freshwater advantage here in Macomb County. Let's protect it. And finally, I think it is necessary to talk about the public corruption that has been so highly publicized this past year. To date, 18 public officials and local businessmen have been indicted in major pay-to-play schemes here in Macomb County. As these indictments have occurred, I've been asked each and every time another one comes out by the media if I thought this gave Macomb County a black eye. My response each time was no, I don't see it as a black eye. I see it more as a welcome change. What I've learned in my years in law enforcement is that people don't speak up either because they're afraid of retaliation or they just don't know who they can trust. I'd like to believe these indictments are giving comfort and assurance to the public that it's okay to come forward knowing that there are public officials out there who will not only listen, but who will act to put an end to this. I hope that what you've heard this evening shows that the state of the county is strong and that it is headed in the right direction. In fact, we could be living in the best of times Macomb County has ever seen. Everyone here in this room is contributing in some way to building the Macomb that we call home. I'll continue to tell the Macomb story every chance I get. I want to thank all of you for giving me the chance or the opportunity to be your county executive, and I'll continue to do everything I can to make you proud that you make Macomb your home. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for celebrating with us this evening, and I want to wish all of you a happy and safe holiday season. Thank you very much.
I feel like new sunglasses, like a brand new pair of jeans. I feel like taking chances. I feel